guys. I'd say 90% of the guys in Death Mountain were very independent people. Mountain people, skiers, campers, hunters, fishermen, men with dogs, dog sledders. We went company to company, maybe lots of times when we first started out. Met many fine officers, some weren't so fine. One colonel in particular that I will not mention at this time, but I unfortunately did not take what was given out. I had a gentleman by the name of Colonel Hampton, came to my help, and proceeded to make me what was called a dog robber at the time, which is also called an orderly.
How did that come about?
Well, Colonel Hampton was in the Bay Area, and I was in the Bay Area, and we got talking, and he found out I was having troubles, and so he was going to take care of it. Until we went on that nasty march up the hill, 1,300 feet, something they call winter maneuvers. Well, I lasted a week, and he sent me back.
That was a D series?
That was a D series. Coming back, unfortunately, I had to walk a great deal of distance back, and then halfway back, I found him in that bag. And so I thought it'd be nice to bring it back to camp, and the MPs wanted to see what I'd bring him back into camp. And the next Musette bag, unfortunately, was a bag full of morphine. Well, you know what happened then. Unfortunately, Colonel Hampton was coming down to camp about the time they were ready to put me away after a couple of hours. And he told him who I was, and fixed things up to into the barracks and went and took care of things for the officers. Shortly after that, there was an opening in the officer's bar, there at the officer's mess, and I was awarded that as well as being Colonel Hampton's personality. D Club, under the auspices of some of Roy Nicholson's people up there, and from there we went up to Soda Springs and learned up there.
And you stayed in San Francisco. Can you talk a little bit about?
Oh, it's in San Francisco. That was we had all kinds of people up there. We were trying to scout the thing, the guard, and a few of the other very lovely people. You know, the person who owned Ski Land was a captain of Ski, but his name was Johnny Clark.
What was the mountain made out of?
Ski Land was made out of cocoa doormats and sprinkled with. What time did you leave? the word Mark.
That's my God.
Captain's name was Crum. He was a redhead. Nice fellow, but he had different too much for that red hair. But he was a fair officer, a very fair officer. Stayed with his group until we went up to Viva. Lake Garda. We went up the top of the hill behind Lake Garda and stayed there for a while.
Were you with Captain Crum when instead of going through the tunnel you
went?
We went
around in ducks.
Yeah.
And up the hill with Captain Crum's group, which was quite a thrill, to be able to get on the water again. We went up there, odds of any aircraft firing down on us, the Germans had it. Next day, war was over. One officer and a dear old Sergeant Evans were killed back there after the war. I believe it was after the war was over. Colonel Hampton came back. I was reassigned to Colonel Hampton. From there we went to Carrie to Pridley, settled in a beautiful manager's, whatever you want to call it, mansion up there. Had a swimming pool.
Ooh.
It was cold.
Oh.
They opened up the swimming pool, it's a lap pool. I joined the swimming team. They told us not to converse with the Yugoslavians because they're unpredictable people. So we kept our distance from them. They had a small armory in the basement. They finally got rid of it. There's a medical captain there, doctor, I can't remember his name now, I've got his book. We started a swimming team for the 10th Mountain Division. And me is looking for good things to go, the colonel was busy. Wasn't much use for me, I went to join the swimming team. We had some good meets. We're all getting ready for the Olympics. And about that time, we had a chance to go to Venice. Went to Venice, saw Venice, beautiful place. Did a lot of traveling through the different cathedrals and different art exhibits. Managed to do the opera in Monica Cini. Managed to meet some people there. And later on in San Francisco, they moved. She was a citizen, came back to the United States, and became friends with her. The war was over. We went down the stage in Florence. You haven't got enough credits to get over back over to the States. I says, well, I've got to beat this. I couldn't get a hold of Colonel for some reason. He was gone. He was usually trying enough to fix things up, so managed to see another officer there. It was a name I will not mention. Very nice, small fellow, a very short guy. He says, you want to go back to the States? He says, yeah. He says, I might be able to fix it up for you. That's how you do that. He says, you've got a Beretta pistol I want. I said, you give me the orders and I'll give you the pistol. Well, we went back on a Westbrook Victory. Now that was a cruise. Bang, slap, up sea. Back to Virginia, back to California.
Was it a nice ship to come home on? Oh, it was terrible, huh?
I don't even mention that. Just a lot of odd things happened on that ship, including lots of money.
Wow.
It was lost.
A lot of gambling?
Oh, yeah. That's all the guys did. Nothing else to do in spare time except gamble, side bets. Then we went back to, I wound up in Camp Beale.
That's where? Where's that? What state?
In California.
Oh, okay.
Sacramento. We were put on leave from there to, from overseas to staging area, and then back to Camp Carson. When we got back to Camp Carson, there was another furlough there. And after that, we were to be reassigned. Those that couldn't get out.
Were you worried you were going to have to go to Japan, too?
Oh, I was always worried about that Japanese thing. That's why I never went to a medic. I like Italian food better than Japanese food. So then I went to see Colonel Hampton, and he says, well, you going home? I said, no. He says, why not? I said, I don't have the points. He says, what do you mean you don't have the points? He said, I put you in for decorations. I said, well, I never got them. So I wrote my dad, had some pull in San Francisco, see if I could transfer to the Presidio. I didn't want to go to Kentucky and over the Army. So the waters came through the next day. That's how fast it transpired. Next day, the colonel comes up to me and says, Graham, here's your orders for discharge. So I went down and canceled my transfer orders, and away I went. Became a civilian again.
How was your transition from being in the military to being a civilian?
Disastrous.
How so?
I didn't know how to behave. Started running around with 16-year-old girls. Came engaged to one, broke up with her. Went on to college, which was Colonel Hampton's wish that I did. Kept up correspondence with Colonel Hampton, his wife.
And so where'd you go to college?
Went to college in Marin, in Kentville. Studied art major. Wound up being an artist and a silversmith. In the meantime, many other things, as a lot of us disturbed veterans did. Everything from selling sewing machines. Served my apprenticeship as a butcher, worked in a sporting goods store and a hardwood store, did gunsmithing and locksmithing for 20 years, then started my trade. Outside of that, it's been all fine. Right now, I might say totally disabled, so I'm living like a king, nice house, beautiful property out here on the coast. Hear the waves splashing, turkeys in the front yard, chipmunks, the whole works. And due to this interview, very fortunate to have Colonel Hampton's daughter here with us for lunch today. That's about all I have to say, but I had some good experiences in the tent.
What would you say your most vivid or your best experience was in the tent?
Best experience in the tent was the camaraderie of the fellows that were the actual tent group. Litchfield, and all the ski group. Major Murphy was the one hell of a mess, but that man. And he did a lot for us. So I can't remember the names anymore, even though I did work in the offices. Well, but most of them were 100%. Except we get some of these West Point boys, and they get kind of stuffy. We had a Colonel Cook there that I didn't exactly admire too much. And we had old Colonel Thomas, and you can't help but remember him. He had one famous old song. He used to get up in the morning and he used to sing it as loud as he could. It was early in the morning, baby, let your pants hang low. Hang low, goddammit, hang low. That was old Colonel Thompson. He got wounded. He was one of MacArthur's old boys. But all in all, it was a good experience. I wouldn't take $1 million for it, mm-hmm. but I wouldn't want to do it again.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What was your
word? With the fellas, yes. Okay. The original fellas, yes. They're all a good bunch of skiers and mountain people.
What was your worst memory? Do you have a specific memory?
The day the colonel got hit. That was a nightmare. And from there on until Riva, Lake Garda, and he came back, it was almost a nightmare. With the exception of, I say, Captain Crum, he kept us busy.
Do you see a lot of poverty there? I guess you did a lot of food trading.
Oh, I mean, everyone was that way. We traded food, naturally. We traded anything that was tradable for the commodity we desired. My commodity was food, drink, and the arts. And believe it or not, I had no use for more to comport with the women. Well, I'd dance, but that was the extent of never take them out, just go to a dance. But food was one of my main features over there, it always has been. That's about all I've got to say to this camera here.
All right. Thank you,
Myrna. This is just a short PS to put in here. It was asked what was the most memorable things I had in the 10th Mountain. Were the days I went skating down at the Broadmoor Hotel, and with the two brothers and Gary Steffens down there helping instruct me in ice skating. All three of them were show skaters. And Merle, if you happen to see this, you were the older than I was, and took this little 18-year-old down there and helped me with my skating. And that was the most memorable part I've had in the 10th Mountain, was the three boys down there skating with me. That was the truth. That was camaraderie. Ever seen you since? I left the company, but it was great. Thanks, 10th Mountain, for these three boys.
Okay. Graham.
Roy Graham was with the headquarters of the 86th Division, Myrna Hampton, conducted this oral history. Thank you, Roy. Taken by Myrna Hampton, Roy Graham was in the headquarters of the 86th Division.